I'll get back to work.
Thank you. Thanks for your service. Welcome back. What you do is important. It matters.
Good afternoon. The U.S. government is back in business today.
And it's all possible because President Obama and lawmakers ended a 16-day budget impasse with a last-minute compromise that also avoided a possible default. Now, most federal workers were off the job for 16 days while Congress battled over a budget deal and almost let the government run out of money to pay its bills. The stalemate ended late last night when first the Senate and then the House passed legislation to fund the government until January 15th and raise the debt ceiling until February 7th. This compromise calls for the leaders of the House and Senate budget committees also to work together on a plan to reduce the deficit. The president spoke today, urging Republicans and Democrats to put their differences behind them.
Now, there's been a lot of discussion lately of the politics of this shutdown. But let's be clear, there are no winners here. These last few weeks have inflicted completely unnecessary damage on our economy. We don't know yet the full scope of the damage, but every analyst out there believes it slowed our growth.
If negotiators don't find a long-term solution, the entire budget crisis could be replayed early next year.
Hundreds of thousands of federal workers started returning to work this morning for the first time in more than 2 weeks. As soon as lawmakers ended the 16-day partial government shutdown, the notice went out to employees to come back today. Vice President Joe Biden greeted federal employees coming back to the EPA headquarters with muffins. With the government back up and running, workers removed the barricades at national monuments like the Jefferson Memorial, tossing the closed signs to the trash heap. Visitors who had been shut out of national parks and landmarks lined up outside waiting for tours. Many museums and monuments reopened today, but the National Zoo won't open until tomorrow. And while people are glad to get back to work, many understand another crisis could come in just a few months.